essential chemicals, some of them are here. Yeah. For instance, acetone, acetic anhydride, yun nandun sa office.
Baka may mag-manufacture dito nakikinig sa atin.
Well, they don't know the formula, fortunately. Pero ang sinasabi po natin, kaya nga yung acetone na yan, kapag may bumili po ng volume ng acetone of 30 liters or more, in a month. Mm. Automatic yan, minomonitor na namin yan at hahanapan namin ng
automatic reporting ba yan?
Opo. At
they are actually, required.
They're required to secure a PDEA permit hindi before they buy that volume.
Hindi pang parlor yan. Hindi pang parlor.
Hindi po eh, kasi yung nagpa-parlor, kulang yan para gumawa
lang siya. So red flag ka agad yun.
Red flag yan.
No, but where do you buy it? I mean, so the retail outlets are required to let you know?
The retail outlets will ask for a PDEA permit from the person. And even the retail outlets have a permit. Mm. And if they dispense that volume of 30 liters or more to a certain person or a business entity,
they're required.
They will report that to us. And even the one who bought, teka muna, may permit ka rin ba? Kasi meron po retailer permit, meron din naman yung end
but
user.
How well does this system work?
We have a...
Yung reporting na to, sinusunod ba?
Oh, ma'am, kasi... Dumadaan po sila sa compliance service namin, which is our regulatory arm, akin to the PNP Firearms and Explosives Office. Kapag may dispensation...
So coordinated to with the police?
Well, hindi na po ma'am, kasi kami na yung monitoring niyan. Dati, there were certain substances that cut across, pwede sa droga, pwede sa explosives. Pero dahil mas madalas ngayon nakikita nagagamit sa droga, nasa amin na po yung monitoring and regulation.
But if the cutoff is 30 liters,
yes,
what's to stop anybody from buying 29 liters here, 29 liters there, 29 liters there?
I-re-report pa rin naman sa amin, sir. I-re-report at i-re-report pa rin yan nung nagbenta. So pwede pa rin sundan ng compliance investigator yan. Masangsang po ang amoy kasi actually na manufacturing.
Yep.
But in this particular case, na maganda yung units nila, and then yun, anong tinanong namin mga gwardiya? And even the those living nearby, napakayo napansin dito.
It's not a pleasant smell, di ba?
It is
why
not.
In manufacturing, it's not.
Pasulasulasok po siya.
Can you compare it
parang
to something?
Ano? Yeah, parang ano?
I'd say it's worse than garbage, for one.
Talaga?
Wow.
Yes.
Mabaho talaga. Parang basura.
It
parang
creeps ammonia. Up your sinuses and it's it gives
parang
you
ammonia.
A terrible headache. Yeah, worse than ammonia. Kunwari, makita nyo na gabi ang activity madalas and people don't smoke in there, they go out to smoke. Indicator yan, because the volatile substances therein will automatically ignite with any spark or any source of flame. And yun nga, most of the activities at night, they bring in these yun nga, boxes of substances with certain markings na usually foreign. Lalo na pag may nakita kayong galon-galon. Ayan. But it's easily detectable in, like yung sinabi niyo, ma'am. In a village where people have high fences, and then they only have much activity at night and not at daytime, red flag na yan.
Yung tinatago yung bahay.
O, tinatago yung bahay. Ang karamihan activity gabi or yung influx ng sasakyan at tao, alanganing oras, closed container. May dalaw silang maleta. It's an observe namin sa kanila. Ang dami nilang maleta.
Ano yung pakunti-kunti yung dala ng produkto?
Ni ma'am eh.
Ganun ba yun?
Talagang luggage bag na malaki-laki. In and out sila, araw-araw na lang ba?
Araw-araw
na lang ba biyahin ito? Hindi naman siya, kasi yung stewardess or yung flight attendant or yung piloto.
Okay lang yan.
Maliit lang yung dala niyan eh.